Hello and welcome to today's video. If you're new here, my name is Meredith and this is a channel about living life with and beyond a chronic illness. So today we are going to be talking all about biofeedback treatment. And we're going to be talking about this because I was recently part of a POTS biofeedback research study. So I was able to receive biofeedback treatment for 6 weeks for the sake of science. And I'm here today to tell you my experience with the treatment, if I liked it, if I thought it was effective, and to hopefully clear up any confusion surrounding what the treatment consists of. So without further ado, let's jump right into it. Biofeedback is monitoring relevant physiological responses in order to understand, predict, and change health outcomes. The process is similar to having someone hold a mirror up to you in order to reflect physiological information. The thought process is that once you gain an awareness of your internal information, you can then identify and correct your mental and physical states in order to improve your health. In the POTS biofeedback study, we focus on 5 different modalities of biofeedback. Those modalities were paced breathing, heart rate variability, skin conductance, temperature, and electromyography. In addition to focusing on these 5 modalities of biofeedback, we also worked on exercises and general health wellness tactics in order to maintain and improve our stress levels. So the wellness tactics that we used in our biofeedback treatment were autogenic training, meditation, reframing our thoughts, SMART goals, and trying to get ourselves on a set sleep schedule. So it is January 10th, and I am off to my first biofeedback training session. Kate's driving, and I don't know exactly what's gonna be in store. I had my first evaluation last week, but we're on our way, and I will let you know how it goes. So I didn't vlog last week, so I want to catch you up on kind of what happened. Last week we did biofeedback with breathing like we did in the first week, but it was a little different because they hooked us up to a heart rate monitor at the same time, and we were able to see our heart rate variance, or how your heart rate changes within a minute, not just your average heart rate for the minute. And with your heart rate variance, we were looking at our breathing rates in comparison to our heart rate variance and if we could get it to coincide with our inhales being on the parts of our variance that you're increasing in heart rate and exhaling on the decrease in heart rate. So that was pretty interesting, and they gave us a little app to do so that we could do it all week as our homework. So that's what we did last week, and I'll let you know what we do this week. So I just finished week 3 of biofeedback, and this week we did skin conductance, which is like how much you're sweating. So they put these little sensors on my hands, and we did our breathing exercises that we've been doing, and we're able to see how our skin conductance goes as we're doing breathing exercises, which for most people may you have less skin conductance. And then we try things like doing stressful activities like counting backwards by 7 from any given number out loud. We tried all different sorts of things, and now we have our homework to do for the week is to practice some mindfulness and some mindfulness meditation sort of things. So we'll see how that goes. So today we had our 4th session of biofeedback, and today we did peripheral finger temperature biofeedback, and we also got an introduction into autogenic training. So basically they connected this little thing to our fingers, and we took note of our skin temperature, and what they did was kind of explain to us how your skin temperature will go down as you get stressed because the blood isn't flowing to your extremities, it's going to your vital organs for that fight or flight response. And so they told us all about that, and we kind of watched it happen. And then the cryogenic training was kind of almost like a guided meditation sort of thing. And we listened to that with our eyes closed, and you know, we're still measuring our skin temperature, and it's a way to relax. And you talk a lot about visualizing your body being heavy or your body being warm and things like that. And all of us successfully in the group were able to get our skin temperature to raise, which means that we were more relaxed and less stressed, which is good because stress equals more POTS symptoms and flare-ups, and no one wants that. It was definitely one that I was able to see a lot of difference in, and something that might be helpful towards me just maybe using the peripheral temperature biofeedback in one of the other modalities. So using it maybe while I'm meditating or doing my breathing exercises as opposed to doing autogenic training. So today we talked a lot about that too, and the idea of taking what ingredients works well for you and what modalities of biofeedback are good and which ones are bad for you, and finding the ones that work and mitigate your POTS symptoms. So I would say overall it was a pretty good session. So I will see you next week when we are doing electromyography and progressive muscle relaxation. I just got back from my fifth session of biofeedback training, and today we did electromyography or EMG training. And basically what that means is that we were given sensors to put on our muscles, like right behind our neck, and we measured how much tension we were carrying in those muscles. These sensors could have been placed anywhere, but just for convenience and consistency sake between all participants in the research study, we all did it on our shoulders. So basically they put them on and we measured how much tension I was carrying for my baseline. And then we did some relaxation exercises to see if we could lessen that tension. And then at the end, we all did a body scan, which you may be familiar with if you've ever done any kind of yoga or meditation or anything like that. It's the kind of thing where you focus on relaxing from the top of your head down to your toes and just kind of like picturing your whole body becoming relaxed, essentially. So we did that, and this week we're supposed to do a body scan once a day or more if you'd like, to try to see if we can mitigate some of that tension that we are carrying. So that was what we did this week, and I'm going to try to implement it more. And then next week we are going to get a chance to kind of go back to any modalities that we found particularly helpful or we have particular trouble with and want to try again. So I'll let you know which modalities I decide are most beneficial towards me, and hopefully I'll be able to give you a little bit of a wrap up and kind of my final thoughts of how this whole process went. So now that you've gotten a little glimpse into what the POTS biofeedback treatment was like, I want to answer some of the questions that I've been receiving in regards to biofeedback. So the biggest question that I've been getting is, did biofeedback cure my POTS? Does biofeedback cure POTS? All those kind of questions. And unfortunately, the answer is no. I definitely still have POTS. And I presume that people are asking this question because I know that there are POTS biofeedback treatment centers in the country in which you have to pay a big chunk of money out of pocket to receive the treatment. So I know that some of the people asking me, pretty much, is it worth it? That's what people are asking. Is it worth it for me to spend thousands of dollars to go to this place that isn't covered by insurance? Am I really gonna get cured? Because some of these websites and treatment centers are claiming that. They're claiming that you're gonna get cured, and they're claiming that, you know, you're going to leave a week or a month later with no POTS symptoms. So if you're someone who is considering traveling to one of these POTS biofeedback treatment centers that you have to pay out of pocket, I want to tell you this. In the description box below, I am going to put some of the apps and inexpensive kind of biofeedback tools and things like that, so that you can have access to those things. I would try that before you spend all that money. I feel like it really sounds like I am bashing these treatment centers, and maybe I am, I don't know. But if you've been to one of these treatment centers and you have something to say about it, definitely leave it in the comments below. I really want to start a conversation about this treatment because I do think that it's pretty new, at least in the POTS world. So I know there's a lot of people who are researching it and want to know more, and I hope that if they find this video, they're not only finding my opinion, but they're also finding some information in the comments below. So maybe hopefully get that conversation started. I do see a lot of value in biofeedback for managing my POTS symptoms. And specifically, the modalities that I felt like really gave me an extra awareness about my POTS were the heart rate variability and the skin temperature. I didn't realize how reactive my skin temperature was to stressful situations and how my body was overreacting to certain stimuli around me and certain stressors in my life. So being able to hook myself up to a skin thermometer essentially and see that when I was getting stressed, my temperature was going down because all of my blood was going to my vital organs because my body is hitting this fight or flight response before it's actually necessary or when it's useful or essential. And so learning that and gaining that awareness was extremely helpful. And then the heart rate variability matched with the paced breathing, when I was able to see my heart rate variability and see when it was going up and down and being able to pace my breathing with that was this excellent way to get myself more relaxed more quickly and to basically return from a level of high stress and high POTS symptoms into recovery mode faster. And that's what I feel like the POTS biofeedback is all about, is that we're gonna have these POTSy moments and we're gonna have these moments where we're really stressed out, but it's how fast can we get our body to recover from that? Or how can we prevent those stressful moments from happening before they happen? So I definitely feel like there's a lot of benefit in biofeedback for the prevention and for the faster recovery time. So the other question that I've been getting a lot is, am I going to continue with this treatment? And the answer is yes. I am going to continue implementing the biofeedback tools that I learned about in my biofeedback treatment research study. So the exercises that they taught me and some of the apps that they recommended to me, I'm going to continue using, and I'm going to continue implementing some of those exercises and the general wellness tactics as well. Managing POTS is all about finding those diets, those pills, those lifestyle changes, those treatments that make your POTS slightly more bearable, and finding them and keep on adding them into your day-to-day life. And eventually, all those little things, they're gonna add up and you're going to have a drastically improved quality of life. So whether it be a new medication or a new treatment, whenever you're trying to find something to help manage your POTS, just remember that it's a lot of baby steps. There are going to be some things that drastically improve your POTS with one pill or in one day or in 1 week, and there are some things that are just going to make it just slightly bearable. But that slightly bearable is slightly more bearable than yesterday, and I think that's just something that we all need to remember in our chronic illness journeys. So I hope that you found this video helpful. If you have any more questions about biofeedback or if you have any experience with biofeedback and want to tell us about it in the comments below, definitely do that and definitely check out those links to all of the biofeedback tools and apps and all of those things if you are someone who is interested in doing biofeedback yourself. That's gonna wrap things up for today's video. I hope I see you next week. Bye.